10 extra days of leave entitlements a year. Sounds pretty sweet, right? Well, that's the deal public service workers in one Aussie state have just been awarded as employees demand a broader and more generous offering of days off.
Following a campaign by Queensland unions, all the state's public sector workers are set to be entitled to an extra 10 days leave per year.
10 days reproductive leave.
Reproductive leave is for both males and females. It kicks in September and will cost taxpayers around $80 million per year. The leave, covering things like menstrual pain, vasectomy recovery, endometriosis, prostate or breast cancer screening, and days off for IVF treatments. And that's all on top of the existing 10 days sick and carers leave entitlements.
Well, it's a fantastic win for Queensland workers. We are taking this to the ACTU Congress, which is being held in early June, and we'll be asking for a commitment for the union movement to get behind a national employment standard so that all Australian workers, women and men, can also get access to this.
Oh, well, I think that's fair enough.
Well, I think that's perfectly sensible.
I think it's almost like investing in, like, your employees. The more the government can do, the better, I guess.
Business groups are not impressed.
These matters are appropriately dealt with through existing entitlements to personal leave. There does not need to be a new form of leave for every circumstance that may arise in the private life of an employee.
I think we've got plenty enough leave already. I think we've got too much, to be quite honest.
Australia's not exactly up there for paid sick leave days when compared to the rest of the world. We have 10, while Austria and Germany offer 6 weeks. As Aussie employees begin to demand more, some workplaces are offering things like pet leave, gender affirmation leave, and lifestyle leave. So will new and wide-ranging paid leave days soon become the norm?
People just can't survive now without wanting something. They need more for nothing.
Wow, joining us now is workplace expert Lauren Anderson. Lauren, I love a holiday, but look, pet leave, birthday leave, special leave, floating holidays, is this really the future?
I think it's interesting to consider the time in which we're living, right? There is a bit of a requirement for employers to offer more, but that's because we're in an incredibly tight job market. So I'd say a lot of these interesting and intriguing leave types that we're seeing are probably a desire to attract more people to these industries.
So are there other types of leave that all workplaces, so the public sector and the private, should consider offering their employees? I would like my employer to pay me and never come to work, if that's an option as well.
I think you'd be a part of a long list of people who might like that type of leave as well.
Including some of his colleagues,
I suspect. No, that's not true. They love me. They love me.
Oh, OK. Sorry, Laura, go on.
Not at all. I think we need to consider the industries in which we work. And I think if we look at some of the recent changes we've seen in the Queensland government when it comes to the leave entitlements they'd like to extend to the Queensland public sector, it comes from a place of looking for challenges or opportunities where they can extend more leave in order to essentially close a gap or facilitate a better conversation within their workforce. So I don't think there's a broad sweeping leave that should be offered everywhere, but it probably would be industry to industry, sector to sector, business to business, looking at what do they need to either attract talent or retain talent or set themselves up better for the future.
A lot of these entitlements always start with government as employers, and it's obviously great for workers, but what will it mean when it trickles down to small businesses who are 96% of the businesses in the country?
I think there's, you know, not all leave is going to be fit for every business. Not all leave is going to be fit for every industry. But I do think it sets a bit of a conversation starter for us as employers to be reflective and look at what can we offer our people to create a better world of work moving forward. Is it in workplace wellbeing? Is it going to be in health-based leave? You know, with the workforce you have at your fingertips, what is it that they need to perform their work better?
I'm down for birthday leave. Really like that.
I've got a bit of birthday coming on right now, actually. I better go.
You can't have 7 a year, mate.
Oh, well, doesn't I can try. That
that's birthday suit leave. Oh, yeah. Entirely
that's
different.
That's when I get asked to leave when I went.
Yes. Lauren, thanks for your time.
Thank you very much.